All right, Floor. So I just wanted to ask you a couple of questions today.
Yes.
We have three different segments. One is about the course. One is a couple of just questions about you as an individual. And then some are actually questions from students that have already completed your course that wanted to follow up with some really unique scenarios. So first we'd start about the course itself.
Yes.
I think the main thing is, what would you say is the main message of your course?
That's an interesting question. So this is a general introduction course into philosophy. And when I prepared for this philosophy course, I thought, okay, what would it be interesting for students to learn when it would probably be, for most of them, their only philosophy course during their university years. So I picked two topics. A little bit of philosophy of science, but then applied philosophy of science, and generally ethics. Also applied ethics. But the main message of this course is to have a counter argument for the students against relativism. And relativism is the opinion that each opinions are all equal and that we cannot say which claim for the good is better. And I think that's an idea that many students have, and I think that it's not a good idea, and that this whole course is actually one argument to refute relativism. So that would be the...
So then, drawing from that, what would you say is the most important skill that students can develop during the course?
The skill would be critical thinking, but one of the things is that critical thinking, that many people think that they can already think critically. But we have a tendency to overestimate our critical thinking skills. And one of the skills is that you should also reflect on your own knowledge and your own claims that maybe you can be wrong yourself. Usually it's easy to point to other people and say why they are wrong, but maybe we should also reflect on ourselves. So it's self-critical reflection also on your own.
So it's the starting with interpersonal critical thinking skills to develop yourself and then to be able to extend that further out afterwards. But
yes,
the first step is looking in at yourself.
Yes.
Okay, indeed. Nice. So with that in mind, what would you say is the actual hardest part of the course for students?
Well, if you give them, we give the students a toolbox of critical thinking, like fallacies, a little bit of logic, a little bit of argumentation theory, philosophy of science. But it gets difficult when students have to apply it to themselves, but also to many cherished opinions in their own life. Like if you tell them about pseudoscience, for example, people understand. It's not hard, but when they have to apply to something they cherish or something they hold themselves, like there will be students who believe in homeopathy or any other pseudoscience. And especially if we also extend critical thinking towards the claims of religion, then people start to get feeling uncomfortable. So it might be this course is also emotionally difficult for some people.
So students should be recommended to embrace being a little bit vulnerable in order to allow themselves to better understand where their ideas or opinions come from.
Indeed, yeah. So it's thinking. Usually, the difference between this course, we already said that in other courses, this is also self-reflective on ourselves. So usually, it's just the object is outside of yourself, and this course, you are also part of the object. So this makes it much more. Much harder, or not intellectually, but emotionally harder.
Yeah, so students are put into a scenario where they have to embrace metacognition, where they have to think about how they think and how they make their own ideas and how they draw those conclusions. And that can be difficult because it shakes their foundations.
It can be that you have some very cherished ideas, maybe they are attached to your core idea of identity, and that they do not hold when have a critical look at the arguments supporting them. So, and that's not something that students are, well, it's new to them usually, yeah. And it's also that it's new to them that they are challenged in these kind of beliefs. Of course, it's a safe surrounding. I'm not challenging any student personally, but collectively.
No, you want to provide a medium in which they can look at this in a safe place and from an academic perspective and try to develop themselves as a person.
Yes.
And the extent to which they do that is up to them, but the hope is, I'm assuming, that they try to make the most of the experience.
Yeah, that's what I hope, yeah. Okay. And learning for many students already do and will make life, significant lifestyle changes. And also, usually there are some students who, usually from a Orthodox religious background, they just don't like this whole course. Mm-hmm. So well, but it can happen. Maybe in years they will think back. So you never know when people are ready for it. At least they have got the ammunition for all the arguments.
So then my final question would be, what is the value in understanding concepts like probability in your course? Because that's drawn on a lot throughout the course in order to really extrapolate us to what is reliable and what is not.
Yes, indeed. We generally, the epistemology deals with how we know things. And generally, we have this idea, we have the epistemology we have in our minds is not correct, and we have not reflected on that deeply enough. Many people think, okay, they are beliefs, they are either true or not true. And usually all the ideas that I have are true, and maybe your ideas are probably less likely to be true. That's what we think. Mm-hmm. That's like folk epistemology. But generally, if you think a bit a little deeper, that your own ideas or our own ideas, they might be true. They are probabilistic. That means that, and you have to rethink how probable, how likely is it that these ideas are true. And then you have to know a little bit about philosophy of science and how science works, and then you can adapt your knowledge claims on that. So you have to, but we have to look, for example, and that's very hard. People think the probability that there is a God is almost zero. Mm-hmm. The probability that the theory of evolution is true is almost likely close to 100%.
Yeah.
The claim that there is anthropocene to climate change has also a very high probability. So that you have, and why do we know that? Because you have to understand how knowledge is generated and how the scientific processes work. So knowing this gives you much more grip on knowledge, and also that you. And it's also not a problem that you know that, okay, I don't know. That's also a good answer. Mm-hmm. And that you know how probably or how likely it is, and that you can adjust your own ideas on facts, on the best possible evidence.
So with all this in mind then, would you have any closing remark for a student that's about to start this course? Any bit of advice or something that they should think about upon the first day of class?
Well, think that maybe what you have learned till now is not the whole picture. Right? That we have that we should, that what you call the metacognition, that we should be start to reflecting on how we know, and not just getting to know new stuff, but also stop and pause on to reflect on this new idea of metacognition that might open a whole new perspective on the world.
Okay. All right, well, thank you very much, and we look forward to the start of the new class.
I look forward to meeting new students.